Okay, so the next step is to select significant information from the transcript and also assign codes and put the codes under their respective research question. And we're going to use manual coding. The reason being that because you may be new to coding process, learning how to do it manually will help. So that when you use a software, you know the basic process of analyzing qualitative data. So using software will be easier for you if you already have the basic understanding. So that's the reason why for this demonstration, I'm going to use Microsoft Word document to do the demonstration. So as you can see here, we have our two research questions, and also we have the labels for the research question, and then we have all the transcripts in one document because we are doing the manual coding. If we were to use a software, we will have each transcript will be on the different document, Word document, right? So we're going to have about, in this case, we would have about five transcripts or five files that we have to upload those files into a software. But now, since we are doing it manually, we have everything on one document, so that things will be very easy when you are doing the analysis, right, the coding process. The research question will help you to select the statement that you think they are important for you. And also, the coding strategy that we selected will help you to think about, after identifying significant information, what you have to do next, right? So we chose description-focused coding. And with the description-focused coding, you identify significant information and then make sure that you understand that information, and then you assign a label. A label could be in between 2 to 5 words to represent that information, and then at the same time addressing the research question that you have. So we bring it under its respective research question after the code has been generated. These are just demographic information, as you can see here. None of this information is important considering the research question that we have. But looking at the interview question 7, the participant was asked, how do you experience burnout? And then she said long hours. Long hours could be significant because it is addressing the one of the causes of burnout, right? So since we think this one is important, we select that information and then we go to review on the document and we click on comment. Then what you have to do is that you decide, okay, now we understand that this, you know, long hours is very simple. We don't have to think too much to understand what exactly participant was saying. We first think about, okay, so now that we understand the statement, what label should we give to this? I think giving it having long hours will be great. So you can use participant own words to do the coding, right? Now our code is having long hours, but we have to put the code under the right research question. So because it belongs to the first research question, what you're going to do is that you first type burnout, causes, and then with column, right? And then you make sure that you bold it so that it just shows to you that this one is a phrase representing a research question. And then you type the code, right? So the code will be having long hours, and then you have to make sure that it's not bold, right? So you can see that now we have having long hours under the research question one, right? And you see that I put this one into quotation marks. So what happened is that if you are quoting participant, if you are using participant own words to do the coding, you can bring these marks there just to show that it's not your own words, but it's participant information or participant own words, all right? So that's why I indicated quotation marks here. So let's go on. So the participant also said numerous clinical and administrative tasks. Looking at this, it's also about the causes of burnout. So we will think about, okay, now that we think that it's important, what phrase can we use, right? So we can use a phrase like having numerous work-related tasks, right? Could be a code representing this significant information. So if you decide, you click on comment, you select that statement and click on comment and type burnout first, burnout causes, because it's addressing the first research question, and then in column, then you type the code, right? Here, because the numerals is also participant own words, you could bring that to show that it's participant own words. Or, you know, you don't have to, but it's just to remind you, it doesn't change anything, just to remind you that the phrase or the words that you are using here are participant information, right? Or their own words, right? And here you have to make it bold. So that's how you're gonna go. You go to identify significant information and label. That's what you're gonna do for all the information that you're going to find. So let's see, when you go to question 8, what do you think are the causes of burnouts? Participant talks about lack of balance with work and home life. So I think it's talking about, you know, not being able to balance work and life. So because of stress at work, he find it very difficult to do to balance work and also home life. And then so as you are going through, you have to think through what participants are making sure that you understand what they are saying. Sometimes you come up with a phrase or a code that is not all that perfect. You may go back and make some changes. You have to be flexible in this process, right? And sometimes it may take some time. And so you just have to be flexible. You just have to make sure that the information that you are, the phrase that you are coming up with or the code best represent the significant information that you have here, and also addressing the research question that you have. You select the significant information. This is about a course, so you put burnout causes, and then you type in no work family balance, right, to represent this significant information. In the interview question 9 was, they were asked about a solution to burnout, and you can see that time with family might be one of the solutions, so that to be selected. So let's select time with family, and then you click on new comments, and then here is addressing the second research question, so burnout solution, and then you type in the phrase that represent or the code that represent this information, and then you make sure that you make the phrase that is representing the research question bold, right? Sometimes you may find another statement that is connected to maybe having time with family, right? So you can use the same phrase for anything that talks about having time with family, right? Let me explain it this way to whether you understand it better, right? See these codes as containers, right? So what you're doing is that, assuming that we have created a container called having time with family, then anything that is really related to having time with family, you connect this container to that, or you drop this significant information into the container, right? So you can see that when you find anything there that is significant, you first have to find out, okay, are there any codes that I've created that can be connected to what I've selected now? If there's nothing there that you have created that can be used to connect to the new significant information that you have selected, you create a new code for that. So at the end of the day, this is how you're going to see. You can see here that I've coded everything. You can see here having numerous work-related tasks is significant information, but when you go here to participants said the same similar thing, right? So you see how we have connected the same code to two different significant statements, well, significant information. Spending time with family. Let me see. So, as I said, it's all about going through, identify significant information and assigning codes to them, right? So assuming that you are using the software, right? So you upload all the transcripts into the software. The same thing, you create containers for the research question that you have. And then when you go to the transcript, you identify significant information, and then you create small containers that will be the code under each of the huge containers, the research questions, right? So for example, you have a container for research question one, you create and you identify significant information, you create a container for that significant information and label it as, based on the code that you give to that significant information, and then you drop the significant information into the code that you have. So that's how the software, generally how you use the software for, right? So this is what I have for you. The next step is to compile all the codes and also tally the code count, and that will be the next step. So thank you for your time.